start over.
I'm just doing like going crazy.
Hello, fellow adventurers. Susan the Sawyer here, coming to you from Skyblock Infinity Evolved with Somnia.
Hello.
And today we are look at this place. It's so big. Somnia's been doing all this.
Just a bit of building.
Anyways, today we are. What are we doing?
I'm fixing something I derped on. I wanted to get a block of iron, and I poured all of our aluminum brass out. So I'm going to try to find a way to put the liquid back in the smeltery. So
you know what you could do is just put another two bricks in, or another two.
Yeah, but then we
have to make another brick of aluminum brass.
I could do that, but then we'd end up wasting lava to get it melted down again. So I'm just going to build, I think a liquid transfer node will be able to kind of pump it out really easily. So I'm going to try to build that, and we'll see if that works. So off I go to do that.
And then I'm eventually working on automating dirt. Right? Is that what I'm doing today?
Yes.
Or is there other stuff that needs to get done too?
I was probably going to work on power, getting a generator up and running. Really, to do the automating of dirt, all you need is you need the barrel, and then you need item transfer nodes. So grab the ender pearl and make some item transfer nodes. And we're going to need more of those anyway, so.
Okay.
I'm going to be making the liquid one. What's the liquid one? I need two lapis. Oh no, wait. Oh, are you kidding me? Do we have any iron?
Transfer.
No. Oh, we do. Okay. I'm going to take the iron first because in order to get the rest of the iron out, we need my thing.
Is it better to make the item transfer node that has the block of redstone or the one with the ender pearl? Because there's two recipes.
Yeah, we've only got one ender pearl, and redstone is going to be an issue eventually. So for the liquid one, we're only going to need one for now. So I'm going to make that with the redstone. But because the ender pearl makes four, I think we should make the item transfer node with the ender pearls.
Okay.
That's my opinion, at least. And we're going to get more ender pearls from the mob spawner. So that's not too bad. I think we need some... I'll make the transfer pipes. I'm just kind of looking to see what we have in here.
Is it easier to make a sorting pipe or a transfer pipe?
Probably the transfer pipe. And I'll make like eight at a time. So just give me a second and I'll make some for you. There we go. So we need stone slabs, glass.
Redstone.
Yeah.
Okay, so I need that pipe, I need regular stone, a chest, and redstone.
Oh, I got my bucket. My bucket trophy, I mean.
Oh, yay. Okay, a chest. I need two pieces of redstone. Do we have any regular... Oh, you're making stone.
Okay. Yeah. We need some glass, though. Where's the chicken stick?
I feel like I there made glass.
Yeah, I can't seem to find any, so I'm just gonna make up another 8.
Okay, here's 4 sand. We can.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna get another 4, so we're efficient.
Oh. I put this in here, I'm sorry.
In where? Oh, in there?
In the furnace. Oh, but it didn't even, like, bake it.
Yeah, we didn't have anything.
That's okay. Well, there was, like, a wood plank in there.
Okay.
Okay. I'm gonna cut this tree down now.
Is there birds in the background?
What just happened?
Oh, we have Tinker's the iguana tweaks. That's what it is. So when
iguana.
Yeah, when we go to let me see, when we go to use our Tinker's tools, you get experience on them, and eventually you can get them improved. So it's kind of
really?
Cool. Yeah. I'm putting the transfer pipes at the bottom of that, or in the bottom chest there. And I'm going to make a couple more.
So what, does this mean that our Tinker tools become more efficient or something?
Yeah, they gain improvements and all sorts of little things, so it's pretty cool.
Oh, sweet.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Wow,
liquid
this
node.
Tree was ginormous.
Yep, look at that. Awesome.
Wow.
I am so
oh, did
good.
You get it out?
I am so good.
That one tree gave me 19 saplings.
20, because I got one in my inventory. So it must have come from. Okay. So.
Put it in the chest. Okay.
Yeah. So what you want to do with the to get the dirt is set up a chest, like an input chest, and suck any items you put in there. So put any saplings, or when we get shears, you can put all the leaves in there, and just have it pipe into the top of a barrel like this, and then put another item transfer node on the bottom, and it will automatically suck out the dirt once it's done composting.
Okay.
They're pretty easy to automate.
Really quick.
Okay, get some iron there. Okay, what do I want to make? Probably a survivalist. Okay, we got that. We got that.
Hold on just a second. I'm going to close my door.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm just sitting here building my survivalist generator. Susie's off adventuring, gallivanting, some might say. I wonder if she's going to cut this part or not. We will find out.
Were you talking to me? I'm sorry.
I wasn't talking to you, but I was talking.
Okay.
You'll see that in the editing process.
I'm going to organize some of this stuff in this chest. I'm going to put all the stone into this middle chest.
Okay. Probably a good idea.
And then the top chest, I'm gonna put mob drops. And what, like, things that we've made.
Okay.
Since there's not very much, it doesn't need like its whole chest. Maybe I'll put tools up there too. And then the bottom can just be like miscellaneous stuff. Are you doing that?
Yep. Sorry.
Okay.
I was trying to do that subtly. It's like, oh, I need some string.
Okay.
Awesome. Guess what I have?
What do you have? Is that an automatic thingy?
Yes. You Yay. Just need some charcoal. And then maybe something to sift. Do we have any dust left?
Yes. Here, I'm gonna stick it in the top chest for you.
Okay, perfect.
Technically, we weren't supposed to go. What are these dead leaves for?
I goofed when I was chopping down trees and accidentally like chiseled them, and then they fell off as dead leaves, and I was like, oh well, I'll just throw them in here somewhere. So we don't actually need them, but yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to come down and see how this works?
Yes, just a second. Yes, show me.
Okay, come downstairs to my humble basement. we got a survivalist generator generating. It's only 5 RF a tick, but it's generating power for this automatic sifter. So this is just automatically kind of sifting the dust, and we'll get our everything from the dust. So we could set it up with like a chest and an item thing to just put stuff in if we want.
Okay.
And I might try to like augment it with like more.
Oh, I just clicked on it. This is cool.
Yeah. So it's going nice. Pretty slow right now because it's only.
Oh, yeah. But hey, it's faster than nothing.
Yeah. but I'm going to try to get some other. So this is kind of like the base one thing that we can do, and then I'm going to try to do a couple of hobbyist generators.
Okay.
Yes. How much do we need? I think I could do that. I'll see what we can do.
What am I thinking of? Oh, there is carpenters. Oh, no, that wouldn't do what I'm thinking it would do. Ooh, what are these? Hobbyist steam engines.
Yeah.
How does it get steam?
You gotta put water in there. So that's gonna be my first thing. Is getting a bit of a water source right beside it. And then you just put coal in there, and it will heat up the water, turn it into steam, and produce power.
Sweet.
It also works with buckets of lava, so I'm also going to try to I'm going to see if I can automate that. I don't know if I can at this point. There might be a way. Let me take a look. I don't know if they would or not, though, because that would seem like it could be easy to do, so. Anyways, we'll see. Oh, I need a world interaction upgrade, though. Which takes 3 diamonds, so we're going to use our first 3 diamonds on that. But I think it's worth it, so.
So wait. Is lava a fluid?
Yep.
So, can you just make a fluid transfer node? And transfer lava from the crucible into these things?
Not directly, because you need it in a bucket. So you need to be able to get a bucket, fill it with lava, and then put it in there. So it's yes, but no.
That's a bummer.
I might be able to do something with that, but we'll see. Let me get this set up and running. And put that much coal in there.
So can I mine these moss stones?
Yes. Okay, do you want to see how much see these guys in work? In work.
What?
Do you guys want to see these steam engines working?
Yeah, let me go pick up this cowl. Oh my god, I almost walked into the water. Okay.
Okay, they're going, but slowly. I think. Oh, no, they aren't. Sorry.
Why aren't they going?
Because I gotta turn them on with this lever, which I'm crafting right now. So now they're gone, but it takes a little while to get warmed up. But once they do, magic.
We don't have much charcoal though.
No, that's why I want to get the lava. Like, if you look here, let me just... so I can take a bucket of lava out of there. And if I try to put it into the survivalist generator, it doesn't go in.
Oh.
But if I put it into the steam engine, it does.
Oh, what did it do?
Okay, so the idea here is that it right clicks with the... with the bucket.
Oh.
But we gotta wait for it to get enough lava in here.
Right.
So, I'm gonna...
So then you could just put a bunch of buckets in here?
Yeah, or like one or two that just keeps circulating in the system. So like I'll have one or two buckets.
Will it deposit the
lava? Well, if I
after that?
If I can get like an item that has like a lava bucket item, I can pipe that into the hobbyist generators. And then it would kind of recycle back into the autonomous activator and get pulled out to go into the hobbyist generator. Does that make sense? Yes? No?
Sort of.
Sort of? Huh. So I made obsidian.
You did? How?
Not on purpose. And sort
Uh-oh.
of causing a bit of a problem.
Weird. You want me to make you a diamond pick? Because I think that's the only thing we can do right now to mine that out.
No, it's fine.
Okay.
There's actually another way.
Is there?
Yeah. But it's kind of annoying.
How? Oh.
Do you want to come and see?
Yeah.
It's the same way we got cobble originally, the block breaker.
Oh. How do you get obsidian? Ouch.
I
Hey,
accidentally.
this
My
block
lava gen didn't
breaking.
work, or cobble gen. So, like, I had a block of lava and a block of water, and yeah, that didn't work. I'll have to figure it out. Anyways, this will work. Never mind. It doesn't work. I'll just break it. Because I don't think we want to waste diamonds on it. Because there's another way of getting obsidian, that's much easier.
What's that?
If you put a block of water on top of a stone barrel and then place lava in the barrel, it will.
But you still have to have the obsidian to get it out, right?
Well, you just right click it and it like look.
Okay, I think I understand.
Yeah.
Like the dust, you just click it out.
Yeah. This takes forever.
This is really taking a while.
At 2%.
Oh goodness. There's a hell of a
Okay,
fire
we're moving our
and
stuff over somewhere else and we'll come back to that. You could do that, you could do that. I'm picking you up, I'm picking you up. And we'll just do that for now. So we have obsidian in our floor.
I think it happens. It should happen sometimes.
It's true. I'm probably gonna be doing a lot of cuts on this one, actually.
Yeah, we're already at an hour and a half. This all won't fit.
This all won't fit. Don't know why I said it like that. Just thought that was funny. Yay, lava gen.
Lava farm.
I'm making a wrench. Get wrenched. Sweet.
Just hit it.
It's not what you think. Okay. I think this is going to be really cool.
What you're doing?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Was really funny.
I've been completely zoned out in putting these blocks in.
Yeah, that happens. I am. Oh, I need more. What I am doing is setting up I'm setting up the lava so that it gets put into buckets automatically and gets sent into the hobbyist generators. So that we
Oh, that's right, okay.
Yeah, so we basically have like passive power gen in a sense.
Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, look at what you're doing.
Yeah, it almost works. Like, look here, if I put it almost works, but there's one little hiccup. So if I power that, just trying to figure out one more thing. So the only problem is I can't get the bucket out right now.
Oh.
So I'm almost wondering if it's the way I'd set it up. Let me try world interaction upgrade.
7 o'clock.
Yes. Let me try the world interaction upgrade and then leave. four and four of these. Because if that works, then we will have like power for days.
Yay.
Transfer node. Yeah, I might look into that. I'll look into that between episodes.
Okay.
Because that would be awesome if I could get this to work. Anyways, okay, to show my viewers the awesomeness that is the Somnia idea, this is going to hook up like this. Do you want to see too, actually? I could explain to you.
Yes.
Instead of just explaining to nobody.
Not nobody. There's people out there watching.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
In like 2 weeks when we post this video.
That's what I meant. Nobody's going to see the awesomeness of this for 2 weeks, so I want to show you.
Weird. I thought I just heard Venderman. They just killed everything in the mob farm. Okay. I'm here.
Okay. So.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So right over here.
So what's going to happen is this autonomous activator here, it right-clicks the crucible with anything in here. So if you put a bucket, it fills it with a bucket. As long as there's enough lava. So once this gets over 1,000 millibuckets of lava, it will fill up with lava. And then this transfer node here is going to pull it out because it's got a filter for only lava buckets. So it won't pull out a bucket, but it will pull out a lava bucket. And it'll pull it out go through these pipes here. And then I've got hyper rationing pipes. So what those do is they only allow one item into the inventory. So it rations. You could do the same thing set up with like charcoal. So you only put one piece of charcoal in at a time.
Oh, and nice.
So what it's going to do is basically put those pieces of that lava bucket into each one of the hobbyist generators. They use the lava, and then the idea is the bucket gets pulled out here in the back and gets put back into the autonomous activator. But for whatever reason, the transfer node is not pulling out the item. So I'm going to figure out exactly how that works. How do I get items out of a steam engine like this automatically? Because any way that I can get that to work would be fine with me. and that's it. So,
To take the buckets out and rotate them back into the autonomous
activator.
Activator?
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
Yeah, so once that's done, this whole system will just keep recycling those buckets. So with like two buckets in here, it will just continue filling these with lava buckets and powering it.
Sweet.
Yeah. So that's basically it. That's my device. That's my automation of the day.
Well, and you automated this.
Yeah. Well, I built the machine and hooked it up to power. Which I guess is automation, but...
Sweet. All right.
Okay, I gotta go get supper.
Do you want to do an outro?
Sure.
You want to do the outro?
Sure.
All right.
That platform looks awesome. It's going to be really cool once we get it like completely built up. That was such a fantastic idea on your part, by the way.
Oh, cool. I'm glad.
Yeah. So in case anybody was wondering, Susie came up with the idea of making a giant spaceship. So that's what we're doing. You took damage.
That's okay. There needed to be a torch. There was a yellow spot.
You're just like, torch!
Just see, like, we log back onto the server and like tons of mobs are like hanging out all over. Like, that would be bad.
I forgot to torch like one area right on the edge. Like, it was a block beneath where all the lit up like building guide stuff was, and so it spawned a witch, and I turned around and there was a witch on the platform. I'm like, ah.
Oh, no.
So I had to run over and kill it. Good thing it wasn't like a creeper like right beside me though. What's that?
That made me wonder if it was lit up enough right here. I know there's no like yellow X's, but
I think the building guide
dark right here.
The building guide actually lights up. Like, it's got a torch inside.
Cool.
Yeah. I don't know if it's the same level of torch, but yeah. So for our viewers, that was another episode of FTB Infinity Evolved Skyblock. We are making progress. We are automating the things. We are building the platform. We are building our spaceship platform, which looks really awesome. And it's going to be really cool.
The level that we're building right now is the basement level, right?
Yes. Yes. So we're going to have to expand the other one.
The tree farms are at, that's going to be the top layer. So, wow, we're going to have so much basement. What are we going to put in it? Dead bodies? No, just joking.
Well, we do have 3 blocks deep, so we could actually bury the dead bodies in there. This went to someplace really weird.
I've been watching a lot of Criminal Minds lately. I find that my outlook on life becomes very bleak. I watched too much of it. Yesterday I binge watched like 16 episodes. It was a lot. Yep. So that's what I did with my time yesterday.
All right. Okay, well, that's our episode for today. Hope you guys liked it. And I'll go into third person mode. There we are. So that's pretty much our episode. And please leave a like and subscribe to our channels if you enjoyed this content, because we want to keep making more for you. And it really helps us stay motivated if you like and subscribe us and all the good things. So that's basically it. Any last words, Susie? Well, not last words, but...
No.
No?
Until next time!
See you guys all later, okay? Bye!
Bye!